Okay, so today we are going to make some antique silver jewelry using some foil tape and some cardboard. Okay, I haven't made this before. This is just an idea I've had, so I want to try it out as well. So let's see how well it works out. So for this I have a silver tape. It's a aluminium foil tape. It's available at all the hardware stores. This is a cardboard piece that I got from a baking store. I think they make cupcakes in this. I really don't know what this is used for, but this I found this like a convenient pre-cut piece of cardboard. If you don't have this, you can just take a normal cardboard and cut it into any piece, any shape that you want. It can be a square, it can be a triangle, circle. Then we have some earbuds, some paper straw. If you don't find paper straw, you can use plastic straw, but I use paper straw because it's number one environmental friendly and it's much more stronger than the plastic straw, and it sticks well with glue. Plastic straw you have to use a glue gun. I'm avoiding using glue gun because this is a classroom activity with kids. Glue gun is not safe when it needs to be done in a very safe environment and needs a lot of supervision. So instead of glue gun, we are going to use white tape. It takes a little more time to dry, but if you want to do it at home under supervision, you can use your glue gun. And then we need a bit of thread. I have taken a thick cotton thread, a thick woolen thread, or a thick rayon thread or jute thread might as well do. Now, for this exercise, I'm going to make a very, very simple design because I just want to see how it works out. If this works out, we all can go ahead and make some more complicated and artistic designs. This glue is very thick wood glue, so that it can dry very fast. I'm going to use very little of it. Remember, the more glue you use, the more time it will take to dry. So I'm going to take the toothpick and I'm going to make the spiral here. If you can see the spiral here. I don't want to use too much glue because that will, number one, it will leave another impression like it. Right. So if you can see here, I've applied the glue in a spiral motif. Now I'm going to take some of the thread here. I'm going to cut it. You don't really need a cutter if you are a kid, and if you are not working under supervision, use a scissor, that's much safer. Okay, so now I want to stick this thread, but I want to make this thread crisp so it's easier to stick. So I will just take some glue and I will rub it into this thread here. So this thread then becomes soft and it's easier to stick. Okay. Now you can see this thread, it's kind of become soft. It's got a little bit wire-like quality. It's not as some of that glue here. Okay, now I want to clean my hands. I don't want the thread to be sticking to my hand when I'm trying to work. when you are working with white glue, if you just rub your hands together, the glue will follow. Now, I'm going to use this toothpick to stick the thread. It would have been nice if I had a hair dryer, because then it would stick faster, but I think we can manage. Yeah. The trick is to use very little glue, because if this was a lot of glue, this thread would not stick. It would, you have to hold it there for a long time for the glue to dry. Now, because the glue is very little, it kind of catches the thread as soon as I put it there, and the moisture gets absorbed into the thread and the thread sticks. I think I'll just leave it there, and then I'm going to work on the, okay, so these, I will cut this straw and I will make the parts that will go around the chain, some additional parts of the jewelry. So I will cut them into equal lengths. Here is one.
It would have been much easier if I had tagged this part with a glue gun. I think that's what I'm going to do next time, and when my students are working on it, maybe I will provide one or two glue guns which can be supervised. For this part, they can use the glue gun. It's much easier than putting this on. Okay, so that seems to be firm enough, but that should do it. Now is the interesting part. So we are going to take this foil tip and we are going to cut out a bit of foil. Let's try, it doesn't cover the whole thing at one time, so we will do half and half. We'll do one half first and then the other half. Tricky. Okay, there, I use the cutter. You can even use a toothpick or something.
anything sharp to get that thing off. Okay, so now this side of the tape is sticky, so you're gonna put this here lightly. I don't want to press it down right now. I'm gonna do half and half. So there you go, first half is on, and then this is what I think is gonna work. I'm gonna take a toothpick, I'm gonna take this cotton bud and try and get that impression of the thread on it. I don't want to stick it straight away. I'm gonna stick it with this cotton bud, so you can see. So we have the silver necklace and the two parts here already. Now we need to make them into antique. So for that we are gonna go that. Oh wait, I need to cover the back. Oh, there you go. A little bit of black acrylic paint. Take a stiff hog hair brush. And we kind of take a piece of tissue. We have our piece of antique jewelry. Now we just need to get a thread, and we need to get a nice thick silk thread and put it in it.